Much like when George Lucas began his beloved space saga Star Wars with Episode 4, Star Wars 2 exists without there having been a Star Wars 1. Only this film fails to draw you in with an interesting backstory, characters, action, impressive special effects, or even any Star Wars. The closest thing you'll get to a Star Wars in this movie is if you happen to be playing with the Jabba the Hutt toy while watching it. Woohoo! Yeah, look at him go!
Ah, this must be hypnosis through hieroglyphics.
I am your protector. We were once very close when you were Captain Gibb. This is a record of events pertaining to your downfall, and is based on your own memories in the hours prior to your redevelopment.
Are they just going to mumble the story to this movie? Why not just do the Star Wars crawling text?
Since interstellar space has so little gas, there are no sounds.
No sounds, no clarity with your words. Is that an RV?
The power struggles between starships are often of less relevance.
You! I told you before it was enough.
And I suggested you were becoming addicted to your pleasure pod.
I could have you executed for this, Captain.
The pleasure pod is a USB?
Ah, my USB pleasure pod has arrived. What a jip.
I am now in preparation. They always give you a night to prepare yourself before.
What is that, the time code?
My name is Geb. A psych prompter to the Admiral Sotenkai.
I would like to think this movie is 97 minutes in so that it would end soon.
Sotenkai was reasonably proficient in bed for an admiral. Among the pillars of power in the galaxy.
Ew, back bush.
Judged according to the norm of the little people. Tau Ceti's rivers contain the valued mineral Crecel, as well as poison worms. Prospecting for Crecel is the sole occupation of the prisoners of the primitive Tau Ceti.
Found a lug nut, keep that for later.
Hey you! Get back! Get back out of there! There are worms in there!
Why are they all wearing gray garbage bags? Maybe if I hold this ice cube up to the sunlight, that star worm will come back out.
You don't have to go anywhere. Reiner and I'll go.
No.
Come on, Reiner.
That's not really an ideal place to have a fight.
You got bone ass for brain.
Hey, can you cook? I tried to make something called oatmeal once.
Probably tasted like Targa shit.
Fed it to the cat.
Died, didn't it?
Ronzo, take care of him. Ronzo.
Let's see. We've got Paul Bunyan, John C. Reilly, and Robin Williams from Jumanji.
Okay, kid. What's your name?
Newstead.
Did someone roll an 8?
A greenie named Newstead. We'll call him Nui.
Shouldn't they be more concerned about the worm in that guy's leg? What is that, a prolapsed star worm?
So this is like your home planet, huh, kid?
Yeah, in a lot of ways.
Ah, star turds.
Hello, baby.
Is he watering it?
Have some more water, bitch.
Is that supposed to be menacing? Launch to D10. Hit or miss. This movie's a miss.
Oh, you mean claim jumpers. Oh, you mean claim jumpers. What do you think I meant? Man-eating grasshoppers?
Well, he's my favorite character now. No, wait. The stick is. Fakest mustache in the galaxy.
Come on, Nui. Put it in the community stash.
They have to share that salt lake amongst themselves.
We have some mock purple in there.
Oh, this ain't mock purple, man. This is the real stuff. Purple flake. Look at it.
What makes you so sure?
Is that just Burt Reynolds in a trash bag?
I've worked every river and stream around this place.
As the fleet began to move again, my critical node was continuing to build on the far side of the galaxy.
Slowly rotating spaceships. The movie.
A gigantic crest was forming.
Somebody's coming through.
I've been traveling through time via this road flare.
You slides are going to have to work a lot harder. Your last load was too light.
He fell asleep on a domino piece.
She found compensation.
Owen Wilson. Send him back.
She enjoyed the pleasure pack and was having an affair with Jessup.
Why'd you call for me?
Let's not make things difficult.
And you're going to make things easier?
I'll try not to make it too hard for you, Jess.
Is that chewing gum on her earlobe?
What are you doing here?
You sent for me.
To wait outside, of course.
My finger smells weird.
Did you ever wonder why they didn't send a man of your skill to one of the pleasure colonies?
All the time.
Do you get to pick the shape of your pleasure pod?
The order from off-planet is that we are to be less generous with synthetic food.
You mean the flight to value, Cassell?
That guy's chest hair is so high it's becoming neck hair.
I doubt that would be very productive. The prisoners would just seek out more natural foodstuffs.
Take me to the sense of her childhood.
So wearing a pleasure pod makes you see in kaleidoscope vision. That guy's just biding his time licking peanut butter off his fingers.
Let's see, KSR-22.
If this guy can kill time eating peanut butter, then I can too.
We're gonna have to go easy on the food until the next pallet arrives.
I thought deliveries were scheduled.
What's up, Jessup?
Listen, you're not supposed to share the same pudding cup.
Well, it seems like the Empire's had a few minor setbacks in the war.
You know, I'm starting to grow concerned over the lack of star worms in this movie.
Jim, you've done your job quite well. In fact, your efforts here have been invaluable.
Thank you, sir.
I've made a note in your service record.
This place is like a club.
You're very kind, sir.
But there's no music or anything interesting.
Please excuse me now, for I know you and Admiral Pelson have strategy to discuss.
I guess you have to live on a spaceship with poor lighting to afford pleasure pods. Burt Reynolds is upset he doesn't get someone to make out with anyone, too.
Yeah, I used to do espionage work.
Ew, he's drinking worm water.
You meet inside?
Mm-hmm. Worms, wart!
Well, we've got our work cut out. Choosing industrial targets and sabotage teams. We'll need the toughest people in the Empire.
Whenever a character talks, it's like white noise. Or the adults from Charlie Brown.
Wow, what a throw!
I'll teach you how to do that, kid.
Why? Don't we have any other weapons?
Maybe they're saving the action for the very end.
Rocks?
Like the Langoliers.
Is that all? You want to join our group? You're in.
I said my name's Tessa.
Okay, Precious. Apologize to her, Ronzo.
No. Such a kind man.
Apologize to her. What? To this little rugrat? I know her school, Ronzo.
Mortal Kombat!
No, I ain't apologizing, no greeny broad.
And it's over.
Don't get up until you've apologized, Ronzo.
Do we shop at the same garbage bag store?
You obviously never had the pleasure check implanted.
Is he gonna vape?
No, I never felt the need for one.
There's nothing more romantic than a pink mosquito net.
Yes, he does.
Now we'll get a target and throw it.
Eh!
Well, it went in the right direction. Let's try it again.
Eh!
Let's try something else here.
This doesn't really look so hard.
Ah!
Oh, shit! Sorry!
Sorry!
Would you like to have some turquoise wine? It's very delicate.
Alright, well, space wine is green. I wouldn't drink that.
You must breathe deeply.
It's like opening a can of star worms.
What about jumpers? We need to protect what we find.
Others have paid me well to teach them.
I want to learn. Teach me.
Dale Gribble wants to learn.
Now, during this first exercise, I want you to remain very calm. Otherwise, we'll be spit at by the slide poised on those rocks over there.
Ah, it's the Cheshire cat. But eyeless.
You want to pet it?
It's more lethal than the Monty Python rabbit. Run away!
Ooh, don't touch it there. That makes it mad.
When do I learn to kick?
You're too impatient. We'll get to kicks tomorrow.
The sequence of events of a relationship in space.
That's good.
Holding a dead animal, fighting, make out. Space life, you know? Oh man, you've got sticks too?
You're welcome to dig with us. What you keep, half of what you find.
Hey, don't play with us, Pally. You ain't had no turn-in.
That guy is all chin and no neck.
Picked the wrong camp this time, Vicho.
What's with you, Wormface?
You gonna be the Wormface?
Watch the worms. Watch the worms! Watch the worms!
He's taking his aggression out on the fish. Fuck these fish! Fuck this rock! Whoa, this is somebody's climax, but unfortunately not the movie's climax.
Empire!
The Empire? From Star Wars? We're finally gonna have a Star Wars reference? Oh, we'll just jump off the cliff already.
I have finished my review of the proposed sabotage teams. I think you both have done a very fine job in screening the possibilities. You found a particularly promising group in one of the prison colonies.
Ernest Hemingway is wasting these lesbians.
Thank you, sir. That was the first time I sensed the danger. If my momentum had not already become so high, I would have known to run.
So this is like a church confessional, but with data all over the screen.
I wondered what Pelson was thinking.
You've never been against a fight before.
I think we should watch him for a while to see what's going on.
You weren't coming back from the river this morning at all.
You've turned Targo on me.
No!
With one of them.
This guy's just upset he can't grow facial hair.
You would. Something hot going on down there. Lord knows. We'll be out in the cold as we get down there and kill them all right now. Come on.
There's more sticks here than you can shake a stick at.
No!
I'm not sure how that t-shirt cannon is supposed to help, but okay. We win! Somehow!
I fixed it so you'll be in exile here for the rest of your life.
Eh, that's not so bad. There's mosquito netting, star worms, and USB pleasure pods.
The Empire is prepared to grant you a full pardon.
That guy needs to shave his Mr. Potato Head mustache.
The Empire might even fall.
That's the least threatening Empire I've ever seen.
Try to remember that Sodenkai was your stepping stone to a chair in the Imperial College, and that Jessup is your brother.
Well, that's good. I'm so glad this movie was bookended by nonsense.
Maybe J.J. Abrams can reboot this franchise too, or just buy the rights from Troma and bury it completely. But either way, Star Wars 2 Attack of the Pleasure Pods is somehow worse than Star Wars 2 Attack of the Clones. And that movie had really terrible tie-in merchandise.
What we need is a woman that can cook!